Welcome students, myself C.A. Sanjay Mutreja. Today we will be continuing with reconstitution of partnership firm, and then in that we will be taking goodwill for you today. What do you mean by goodwill? Goodwill is the value of reputation, good name, business connections which help the firm in earning more profits. How do we earn goodwill? We have to constantly provide quality goods and services over a period of time to earn a good name for us, and that will bring back the customers to the same place again and again, so that we are able to earn more profits, and this increase our value of goodwill. Next point, what are the factors which are affecting the value of goodwill? It means, how do we increase or decrease the value of goodwill? First point, the nature of business. If we are having high value production or monopoly production with a very stable demand in the market, naturally we are going to have more goodwill for us, because there is no problem in selling the goods, then we'll be earning more profits. Second point, location of our business. Sometime we are having a good location, that is near the marketplace, or our raw materials are very easily accessible. That reduces our cost of production, which increase our profit, and that increase our goodwill, because goodwill means ultimately you are getting more than what other people are getting. So this is goodwill. Third point, efficiency of the management. If our management is truly efficient and they are able to achieve their targets in a very easy manner, then efficiency of management will increase the profit, and when profits are increased, naturally our goodwill will also increase. Next point, market situation. If the market situation is in our favor, like our products are in high demand and we are able to enjoy the patronage of our esteemed customers, then naturally our product will sell like hotcake, and that will increase the value of our goodwill and profits also. Next point, if we are having some special contracts, like we are having contracts with government institutions or a big firm, a big private firm, which is, or we are supplying to the whole nation, you know, then our product's demand will increase, and when the demand increase, production increase and profits also increase, and we get more profit, then we get more goodwill. Next point, if some special patents or copyrights, any example can be taken, of a good company is with us, that is definitely going to attach value to our products, and that will increase the value of our goodwill and profits also. Now, why there is a need for valuing this goodwill? There are six cases in this. First, whenever there is a change in the ratio of partnership. Second, whenever a new partner get admitted. Third, any partner retiring, or there is a death of a partner, or we are dissolving the firm, or amalgamation of one firm with another firm. Let us come to one by one. When there is a change in profit sharing ratio, that is, if some partner gets more and the other get less, now the person who is sacrificing, he must be compensated for the value of that goodwill which was earned when he was getting more. So we have to value the goodwill and give his due share, that is the sacrificing share, to that partner who has sacrificed it. And who will give that share? Naturally, the person who has gained it. So gaining partner will be giving to sacrificing partner his share of sacrifice in the value of goodwill. Next point, in case of admission, when a new partner is admitted, then the new partner must compensate the sacrificing partner for his share of goodwill. We have studied it in the last class. Next, in case of retirement, one person is retiring. He has earned goodwill for the firm when he was a partner for so many years. Now, when he is going out, he must be given his share, that is his due share of that goodwill which he earned for the firm. So, in retirement, we also value goodwill. Next, in case of death, if a person dies, his executors are also to get that value of goodwill which was earned by him during his lifetime. So, we also value goodwill in case of death. And when we are dissolving the firm, that is, the partnership firm is getting over and we are selling the assets and liabilities, naturally we will sell the goodwill also. And for that we have to value goodwill. So, goodwill will be valued in case of dissolution also. And the last case is, in case of amalgamation of firms with another firm, or if the firm is being taken over by a company, then that particular company or that particular firm which is taking over, that must compensate all the partners who have earned goodwill for that firm. What are the methods of valuation of goodwill? There are three main methods of valuation of goodwill. First, average profit method. Second, super profit method. And third, capitalization method. In the capitalization method, we have got two parts. First, capitalization of average profit, and second, capitalization of super profits. Now, let us study them in detail. Average profit method. In this case, what we do is, we take the average of all the year's profits which is given to us. Let us understand this first by an example, then we will conclude it. Suppose we are given profits for 4 years. First of all, we have to total them. The total of this is 60,000. And when we divide it by 4, that is the number of years, we get 15,000. What is this? This is the goodwill calculated by average method. If it is mentioned in the question ki you have to take 2 year purchase or 3 year purchase, then you have to multiply by that multiplying factor. What do you mean by 2 year purchase? It's written nowhere. What do you mean by that? But it simply means that it is a multiplying factor for that particular amount. Suppose it is written 2 year purchase, then I will multiply 15,000 by 2 and will get the value 30,000 of goodwill. And if it is written multiply by 3, I will simply multiply by 3. Now, the second method is super profit method. Super profit is equal to average profit minus actual profit. Super profit is equal to average or actual profit minus normal profit. Now, what is normal profit? Normal profit is capital employed in the business into the normal rate of return. Capital employed into normal rate of return. For this, we must understand what is capital employed. Capital employed is total assets of the business minus outsiders' liabilities. Because capital employed means what you have invested in the business, and that is outside liabilities, leave it, and what remains is your own money. That is capital employed. And what is this normal rate of return? Which everybody is earning, that is normal rate of return. So, we will multiply capital employed by normal rate of return to get what is the normal profit other people are getting. And if we are getting more than that, only then it is our goodwill. Otherwise, there is no goodwill. It means if we are earning more than what others are earning normally, that is called super profit for us. And that is our goodwill. Similarly, in this case also, if it is written 2-year purchase or 3-year purchase, simply multiply by that. Third method is capitalization method, in which I told you there are two ways: capitalization of average profits and capitalization of super profits. Now, what do you mean by capitalization? Let us take it through an example. If we are earning average profits of 20,000 and normal rate of return going in the business is 10%. This means how much capital shall I employ to get this 20,000? Let us see. That is called capitalized value of our business. 20,000 is 10%, then what will be 100%? That is 2 lakh rupees. It means we must invest 2 lakh rupees to get 10% return, 20,000. Now, if I am getting more than that, then it is goodwill. Okay. Now, suppose I have invested only 1,50,000, but I am getting 20,000. That means, in fact, normally I must be getting 15,000 rupees, 1,50,000 into 10%, but I am getting 20,000 rupees. So, this 5,000 rupees, what I am getting is, what is? That is super profit. So, in this case of average profit, how do we calculate the value of goodwill? First of all, we will calculate capitalized value of business, that is 2 lakh, and then we will deduct what actual capital we have employed, that is 1,50,000 rupees. I gave an example, we have employed 1,50,000 rupees. So, out of this 2 lakh, we will be deducting 1,50,000 rupees, our actual capital, and then we will be able to get 50,000 our goodwill. This is goodwill by capitalization of average profit. Second method is capitalization of super profit. As you know, super profit is what? It is actually goodwill. So, suppose I am earning 5,000 as super profit and the normal rate of return going in the firm is 10%. If 5,000 I am earning more, which is equal to 10%, then what is the value of my goodwill? That means if this 5,000 is 10%, what is 100% value of my goodwill is 50,000. It means super profit is always due to the goodwill part. So, in super profit, we can calculate goodwill directly. But in case of average profit method, first we have to calculate the capitalized value and then we have to deduct actual capital employed to get the value of goodwill. But one thing to remember, we have to multiply by 2 or 3, whatever is written in the question. Today we have understood the meaning of goodwill, how to calculate it, and what are its fine points. In the next class, we will be discussing the accounting treatment of goodwill. Till then, thank you very much.